Lizzie, I want to talk to you about one of my former loves, the Alaskan Malamute. If you want a dog that looks at least as good as a Siberian Husky, it is much, much easier to handle, doesn't howl that much, is a relaxer with escaping. Hoi hoi!
Kom braaf, hè, joh. Nou, eerst is het broodje lekker. Ik weet niet wat
het deed. Ja, dat
klopt. Die worden weer spelen, joh.
Hoi, hoi. Wat is as least as fluffy. Siberian Huskies, you have in two varieties, eh? The one is has a shorter hairs, which I like a lot more, and then you have the fluffy, woolly type of huskies, which is like more of a show type of thing, because people wanted to have even woolier, more fluffy type of huskies. Alaskan Malamute fits a little bit in between, so it's woolier than a normal Siberian husky, but not as woolly as woolly huskies are. It's also a lot more strong, so it brings you a lot more mass, broader shoulders, stronger, whereas the Siberian Husky is more of the speed polar dog. The Alaska Malamute is more like a freight train. Hoi hoi!
Hi.
Hallo! Gaat weer goed met de voeten?
Ja!
Dat is fijn! Hoi hoi, het is ook groot geworden.
Ja, ik wilde net zeggen. Het is al loop geweest.
Ja.
Sorry, dat is niet handig. Ik ga snel door, want ik moet weg.
Ja, is goed, ik ook. Hoi hoi. So you get all those factors rolled into one. Also a thing to notice is that the fastest huskies are not Siberian, but Alaskan. Alaskan huskies are orange red huskies. That means that they have more other dog blood introduced to make them faster and run harder over longer distances of time. Whereas Siberian Husky is just a dog that looks pretty and was once used for the original purpose of pulling sleds. And of course, Siberian Husky is a good dog. Yeah? From the current show breeds, it's one of the best sled pulling dogs. But it's in an entirely different ball game as you compare it with, wacht even, with Alaskan Malamute. Alaskan Malamute might not be fast, but it's strong. And fast is also a more subjective term. Huh? In my humble opinion, if you look at the face of an Alaskan Malamute, you see more of the wolfish looks. Let's come, balletje, as compared to that of a husky. So you get a lot of benefits with that, a more natural type of dog. And also, what I really like is that they are quite laid back, also good for children, a little bit challenging. Spikey? Balletje. This is my dog. Spikey! Daar is het, ja. Wachten, hè. Wachten. Hoi, hoi. Hij wil ook een balletje. Hey, jij hebt ook een balletje, ja. Sorry, had ik niet gezien. And you get a dog that is easier to handle. It's also very friendly with children, relaxed nature. So that was, if you want a polo type of dog, that is a balletje, FCE registered, then this could be the best thing. There's something very close to the Alaskan Malamute, which is called the Eskimo dog or the Greenland dog. The Greenland dog is a little bit smaller, a little bit more used. Hey, los, balletje. Balletje. More used for work. Also, this type of dogs are more for maximum strength and maximum pulling capacity. That's what they are all about. So why would you ask me if that is what I like, this wolfish, charm, natural type of dog? Why would I end up with this little black terrier throwing balls in the field? Yeah, that's a whole different story. I made up a video about this topic as well. But to put it very simple, less hair, less howling, easier to carry, still a big enough dog for the family, good for children, and all around very pleasant companion. Achter. Hoi hoi. Nou, dat balletje ook gezien, hè? Goed zo. Dat is braaf, Spijkie. Balletje. Balletje. So when I... Wachten. Wachten. Goed zo. So how did I came with this fixation of this wolf type of polar breeds? I think most has to be that I like the natural view, I like the nature, I like the original type of dogs, which are able to perform, are healthy, and still in touch with the natural surroundings. And the second point would be, I love to read, and I read a lot of books by Jack London. Whereas Bak of Call of the Wild, wachten, balletje, balletje, was apparently a hybrid between Scott Shepherd with a collie and St. Bernard, to give it both the sleek natural looks and build of its collie ancestors, balletje, but also the strength, size and mass of St. Bernard was introduced. And also, if you look at the other books, for example, White Fang, which was a hybrid between wolves and sled dogs. And White Fang would look a lot more like your Alaskan Malamute. They also say that still a lot of wolf blood has been infused, but it's tamed down. Sometimes also those Inuits or other Eskimos who just let a female dog be crossed with wolves to get a better, stronger dog again. But if you look at that natural performance type of dog, also this little guy, you see him exploding out of the corners to catch his ball again. He's from working stock, hunting parents, balletje, balletje, balletje. And even more a natural type of dog, because a wolf doesn't pull sleds, just hunts. And of course, you get a different type of coat. It's not so much an all-weather coat, but still a very good coat that protects them against injuries. It's very flexible in his skin. So even if sometimes, appearance-wise, they look nothing the same, they still both performs, balletje, performs better animals. Quite laid back as well. So this is a terrier, but it's not that hyper. It just gives something to do, gives it a way to explode its energy and give it some mental stimulation when you go outside. It's quite an easy, relaxed dog inside. Goed zo, balletje. Dat is braaf. So that hopefully answers some of your questions. The thing is, if you have like a 40 kilogram of Malamute male, or even 50, 60, and some are getting that big, it's quite hard to take them everywhere. Whereas this, you just put on your arm if needed. Also, isn't that intimidating? It just looks like a miniature Labrador to some. And it's even healthier. Smaller dog breeds, they mature faster and they keep in a vital state for a longer period of time. So I hope this concludes this question. And if not, please ask me about it again. Have a nice day. Bye bye.